Again, you seem to be basing morality on revelation to some extent, that one must assent to the Buddha's perception of karma.
I think to some extent Buddhism and Buddhist ethics is based on revelation.
Hmm.
It's based on a revelation by another, more experienced, enlightened human being. But it's only a revelation, as it were, for the time being, until such time as you can achieve that state in and from which you will perceive things in the same way,
mm.
so that revelation becomes discovery.
Mm. But then does that mean that the unenlightened individual can't perceive the operations of the law of karma for himself?
The unenlightened individual can perceive the operations of the law of karma for himself within a limited time scale, certainly within the limits of this present life. Perhaps he can also have some, as it were, rational experience of the operations of that law of karma through the study of what nowadays are referred to as cases of alleged recollection of previous existences. There does seem to be a residue of such cases which have been, so to speak, proved or demonstrated to actually have taken place. And in the case of those cases, one can perceive very often not just the fact of rebirth, but the operation of the law of karma. So in that case, one would be accepting the operation of the law of karma as a basis for ethics on rational grounds to at least a limited extent.